I know what you might be thinking. Who is that handsome fella right there? That's me. Getting my ass kicked. Why am I getting my ass kicked? It's a long story. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Raymond Wallace. I'm a musician, a lover of nature, and a film enthusiast. And I was born with a rare birth defect called PFF, which stands for proximal femoral focal deficiency. Basically, it means I was born with a shortened femur, aka a little leg. Some people perceive it as a disability. However, I perceive it as a superpower. I don't want to get into boxing. It's really quite simple. I like a good challenge. You know what I mean?
I'm sure there are some things I'm going to have to accept that I cannot do. I can probably do things that are very close. I can try very hard to imitate it, but there are some things that I'm not going to be able to do physically for obvious reasons. And I'll accept that. That's fine. But it will not stop me from learning how to box. It's going to be a while. It's going to be a challenge.
Alright, so it's Monday, September 16th, and today I started training for my boxing documentary. It's about 8:30 in the morning, and on the agenda for this week, the entire week, today through Friday, I'm going to be working on my stance and my footwork and, you know, basic jabs. This is going to be something. This is going to be something. Challenging myself for 5 weeks to train as an amateur boxer and go toe-to-toe with an opponent of my choice. I've dedicated my first week to analyze my natural posture as well as seek out any limiting factors that may occur during my training. I need to get my cardio up. You would think a motherfucker with one leg would be able to hop a bunch, do a bunch of jump rope, but that is not the case.
So right off the back, as far as my footwork goes, I'm noticing I'm going to have to adapt to picking my foot up. I drive my foot quite often when I'm working on my shadow boxing or really when I'm doing anything. I drag my prosthetic, so I need to work on picking that foot up. In addition to that, I do need to work on keeping my back straight. I have a curve in my spine. I don't know how well it's going to work. Well, I'm going to make it work to the best of my ability. That's probably the biggest challenge in this, is just learning how to make, you know, what I got work with just boxing in general. I'm making it work the very best that I can, because I want to, at the end of this, like I said, I want to be able to, you know, last in a round. That's it. A couple other things to include. I need to work on keeping my hands up. I keep them up, but I keep them a good distance away from my face, which really doesn't make any damn sense, but that's another thing I gotta work on. And really just keeping my foot in time with my fist and keeping my body in tune with his entire self, rather than thinking about, you know, the bottom half and the upper half of me in two different segments. because that's what kind of screwed me over.
Respectfully, I was not granted permission to show the footage from Kay's camp. However, I was able to get a couple of shots of the equipment we had used, just to prove that you don't need a gym to stay fit. Key practices during my training at Cage Camp include keeping a proper diet, knowing endurance, and using my strongest leg to my advantage. By placing my rear leg, my strongest leg, in a way that supports my entire body and my stance, I'm able to find a better balance and direct my energy towards a more powerful and forceful punch. But of course, I'd have to keep training if I was going to be good enough to face an opponent.
And I'm getting mighty tired of your trifling ways and of listening to that jackass Bray.
When I was younger, and I was in school and everything, kids would always ask me what happened to my leg, naturally, because, you know, they're curious. And I used to make up all these kind of stories to tell them. I would lie like a motherfucker. I would lie my ass off. You know, I would tell them kids, like, I shark bit it off, lunch lady cut off because I snuck into the cafeteria and I figured out what they were putting in the food and they served my toes the next day. I got all kinds of stories. Learned a lot of case camp, a lot of fun, a lot of intense training. And today, because it is Sunday, I'm supposed to be resting. I did miss a day last week, so I figured I'd come out here and work a little bit. One of the most important things I did learn over there is that I need to change my stance up a little bit. I came out here to the field I grew up in, practice. Let's see what we can do today, y'all. One of the best things about field day is you gotta use whatever you find. And check this shit out.
Mobility. In my case, it is the hardest thing to gain, but the most rewarding to obtain. been a hard week. Working on my lower body, my legs, my feet. Next week, it's gonna be even harder. Full body. And it's a week of training. And then, the fight. Alright guys, we're 2 weeks into the fight. Today I am setting up to do a photo shoot with my challenger, my opponent. He's gonna be pulling up soon actually. Let's see.
Allow me to demonstrate the skill of Shaolin, the special technique of shadow boxing.
Poisonous!
My name's Taylor, this little 20-year-old thug out here in Monroe trying to grind him, get up. We got a fight out here on November 2nd. Come out and see it. Someone's getting knocked out.
Poisonous. Poisonous paragraph, smash a phonograph in half. It'd be the inspector Jack on the wall path. First class, leaving mics with a cast. Causing ruckus like the aftermath from guns blast. Run fast, here comes the verbal assaulter. Rhymes running wild like a child in a walker. I scored from the inner slums abroad. And my thoughts are raging soft. I slice the mic from the door. First criticized, but now they have become mentally paralyzed with hits that I devise. Now I testify, the best is I. Rebel I in S, your highness. Blessed to electrify. Truth that I reveal across the amateurs who scream, they keep it real. Tees are black down, hoodied up in fatigue. Part-time minor leagues, receive third degrees. Attack like a wolf pack, once I pull back, the guard you and bust through like a fullback.
Yo, you 14 karat gold slum computer wizard. Tapping inside, my rap pain causes blizzards. The wildlife that kills for ice tripe like by the digits. Gorillas injected with strength for 80 midgets. The earth spins, ruins, rap exotic blends. Let my peeps in, niggas gasping, swallowing aspens. With a dosage, you overdose it. Explosives, my posters, hypnotized with hypnosis. I sell goods, my whole clan is on the run like natural born killers. Record breaking the album thriller. Got access to tear gas, bombs, and rocket launchers. Blow like dope, killer bees is what I sponsor.
My opponent had been chosen. I was nervous. I was running out of time. All right, y'all. I've got 2 weeks to the fight. And after reviewing some footage of my fighter, I know I got a chance. I have to have a chance. Both of us got a chance. But it's about willpower. At the end of the day, it's about willpower and training hard. I will continue to train hard, and I gotta keep the mentality that I'm gonna whoop his ass. So that's the mentality that I have. But what I know now, I know that if I can improve my balance and if I can work on just going forward, I will be successful. So I gotta practice that. I've been incorporating a bunch of drills that I've learned in Tai Chi, and just things that I think are gonna help me with my balance, and things that I think are gonna help me with my speed, my footwork, as well as my punch. I gotta work on punching pretty hard, because I know that he can pack a punch. So we're gonna work hard, we're gonna find the result. Let's do it. Morning, y'all. So we're gonna have before the fight. And I'm waiting on Taylor to show up so that we can have an hour worth of sparring. We're sparring today not only to kind of test out each other's styles, test out how each other fight, but also to train a little bit, to learn, to teach each other. So this is gonna be interesting. It's gonna be fun.
There you go. Ugh.
at it. Your eye on the ball. Like it's a big old bug flying around the fucking room.
Say your name one more time.
Logan Eason.
I need the crisis. I need to. I literally fight in a week, so. Look at this. Kind of flat on the way to Fort Mill.
So we're trying to hatch a plan.
Logan came with me.
Yeah.
Like this little. Yeah, say hi. Home team. We getting this shit fixed.
Still a little too tall. I gotta go in there, man.
All right, so I broke the, I don't know what it's called. I'm gonna call it a double shovel. I broke Sam's double shovel, but I'm gonna just give him mine that I bought today.
I felt ready.
steps.
It's more, is it stamina?
Day of the fight and we're getting ready. Look at this. That's a ref.
Second 2019, we're about 5 minutes away from going toe to toe in the ring, and this is my first fight. I'm a little bit nervous, but I'm really excited. So let's get into it. I trained a long time for this. Thank you for everybody who supported me, who helped me train, and thank you for everybody who's coming out to watch. I ain't here yet, and thank you for everybody watching right now on video. Let's get into it.
I've paid my due.
All right, to our right, we have Taylor Shortell. Height 5'10, 165 pounds. To my left, we have Raymond Wallace, 5'5, 120.
And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my shells and kicks in my face, but I come through.
And I need to go home.
Whoever punches somebody in the
walls get termites.
I consider it a challenge before the whole human race, and I ain't gonna lose. I need to
I'll be ready for the next one.
King D.
I got the vision, baby girl, I might make a flick about your whole life. Invite you to the crib and spend the whole night. Film around the candlelit lights. I'm hanging with Isha, Lucy, and Danielle. I'm repping my WP, they can't tell who flyers, who dying trip, who honest, who got bills. I'm coming up young king in spirit you can't kill. Yeah, only depending upon will. Yeah, give me a shorty to come feel the heat and bone chills. What's fiction, what's real? Been blessed by the kiss of the moon and I feel. Baby, you looking fresh, putting me through the test.